What's up, YouTube? Noisy day at the junkyard. Just a quick flashback for this Honda Odyssey 2000, aka the transmission eater. So this is the second generation of Honda Odyssey, or Honda Minivan if you want. Very nice design, and I'm doing this review because we still have this on the road in Canada. So despite all the rust, as you can perhaps see here, we still do have people driving this for some reason. Surely because they enjoy the vehicle. Let's just hop inside so we can cut a little bit on the noise. Again, second generation of Honda minivans, and if I'm not mistaken, this is the first minivan that got two sliding doors on one on each side, which was very nice and convenient. The car does feel quite spacious inside. The seats are fairly high up the floor, not very high up the floor. Let me try to film myself a little bit. But at 6 feet tall, I do sit relatively high up the floor. This is what moms love. And I can tell you, as you get old in your 40s, 50s, 60s, you will like that too. For some reason, male or not, we do like sitting higher. It's like a truck sitting something. Very spacious inside. One of the things that I do like about these cars, look at this, what's going on here. You do have this kind of table that you can flip and just toss on the side, but all the space here, basically you can just walk and sit behind or check your kids or check your dogs, whatever else. Excellent, really nice. And from what I've seen, newer minivans do not have this design, this kind of walking area here. They drop that and they just put that center console, which takes too much space in my opinion. Not much to say, this is typical Honda, but this is the generation. Again, this one is a 2000. This is the generation after the EF Civics. The second generation after that one. So there was the EF, I believe the EG, and this is the third generation. You can see the dashboard with those digits, typical for that time, in perhaps around 95-2000 Hondas. Spacious car inside. Look at the space behind here without the rear seat, so when it was removed. Big glasses, good view all around. It's not a problem at all. Simple design. Personally, I think the design of this dashboard, it's smoother, but perhaps it lacks some character to it. It was that much fun as the Honda 90, from around 90, the year 90. Those Hondas had more quality, perhaps also were better screwed cars, and had kind of nicer look to them. Just wanted to talk and show you a little bit around of this car, because we are not going to see them for too long now. Again, this one was called, I'm calling it transmission eater. Some people would disagree and would say I had it till 20 years, never had a problem with transmission, but I do not believe that, sorry. These cars did had very high transmission failure. It was just weak points of the transmission because the car was too heavy. Honda kind of rushed this into production, and they tried to match it with that transmission, which was not properly designed, basically. Okay, so it's just a very short review for this car, not review, but walk around, basically. Like I said, I still see this on the streets. Not too many of them, but they are still there, and just people don't want to give up on them. Perhaps they are replacing their transmission, rebuilding the transmission or so. But for some reason, people just keep driving these things, which tells you that it wasn't that bad of a car, actually, besides the transmission. Perhaps surely there are other things that went wrong on these cars. The AC condenser, which was prone to rock heating and stuff like that. But compared perhaps to more recent Honda cars, these were better built back in the days. Perhaps this was the last good, well-built generation of Honda. Not saying that the other were bad, but it was just perhaps the last car to kind of proudly wear the Honda badge on it. Okay, thanks for watching.